Last week on Shipwrecked. The men had a chance to escape the island by way of a boat driven all the way from God knows where by Dave, Brad's mate from the mainland, who's probably best known for his involvement in the great 2008 permed hair debacle. The rescue vessel was sunk to the bottom of the ocean to lay rest amongst the clownfish and seahorses, who unbeknown by most people can beat their fins up to 50 times per second. The seahorses can. John put his shoulder out, diving in slow motion to stop a flaming coconut, and Gav sang a Michael Jackson tune, Billie Jean. The Michael Jackson tune, Billie Jean, while Freddie Mercury turned in his grave to a more compromising position after Petra led the boys through the vocal garden of Bohemian Rhapsody.
Dave.
Apologies.
John.
I had a whistle in my ear that I'm going to do it again.
Don't do it. Oh, what would you do that for?
Hey, it's quality stuff.
It's not quality, it's bringing the show down.
Cheers, it's
wrong.
It's good. Sorry.
Don't do it again. How are you going, Gab? You feeling better, mate?
Still got my cough. Thanks for asking.
No worries, mate.
Yeah.
How's the weather treating you?
A bit cold here. Cold.
It's just starting to warm up here.
Well, I don't care. Ahoy there, mateys. We're meant to be on an island or under the... all sharing the same temperature, the same sun. Just keep it together. I can't be pulling you back into line every time you step out of line. This week, we find the boys discussing the greenhouse effect and how it changed a childhood when it got put right in the middle of a backyard, covering the cricket pitch while a single feather floating to the ground seems to be missing a bird. The moon is gone, the sun is out, my left big toe is full of gout. I plugged my boat with chewing gum and a yo-ho-ho and a bottle of rum.
I love that song, yo-ho-ho and a bottle of rum.
Well, come on then, matey, let's sing a bit. 50 men on a dead man's chest, yo-ho-ho and a bottle of rum.
15 men on the whole ship's list, yo-ho-ho and a bottle of fucking rum.
6 men lost and Dave just left, yo-ho-ho and a bottle of rum.
Here we go. Oh, I can't read, this is too small. Fucking zoom.
Just make it up, Petra. Ron is sporting emu legs, yo-ho-ho and a bottle of rum.
Don't press the wrong button,
though. Oh, never mind, I'll sing it out. Pronto's here, John crashed a plane, Gav's chocolates were quite insane. Jimmy's had a bit much sun, we'll fix it up with a bottle of rum. Wilson's sister round, not tall, a hole cut in a tennis ball. The goat race on the beach was fun, a lighter up your bum. The island's great, you all should come, but bring some food, cause we've got none. The seagulls flying overhead. Let's move this shit along.
Hey, I'm reading the old script. Let's get back onto the old thing in hand.
You're quite right, John. I got a bit carried away singing the old sea shanty, the old yo-ho. Oh, you're quite right. It was all jolly at the time, but now it's time for action. Action, boys, action.
Petra, I was just thinking about what you said last episode and was wondering if it was true or not. And if it was, did you sing it because it would sound more subtle than if you had just come out and told us?
Jimmy, what are you talking about?
Oh, don't act as though you don't remember.
Are you talking about the song from the last episode?
Was it a song or was it just a well-composed confession written and sang to sound exactly like a song?
Jimmy, I'm fairly sure it was a song then.
Oh, you are you, John? Well... Mister, call off the manhunt because I'm fairly sure he's innocent. I found the confession note over by the rock out the front of the cave, the very rock he was sitting on when he let slip that he committed a murder.
Murder?
What? When he sang the song?
When he spilt the beans?
If I murdered someone, why am I not consulted about anything in my life?
Are you talking about those Queen lyrics?
She didn't write this, Mr. Wonker. It was PetraChelli. Ron, put this man under citizen's arrest.
What? I can't do that.
What do you mean you can't do that? Because you're part emu? I'm pretty sure that's why they say the strong arm of the law and not the legs.
It's got nothing to do with it.
All right, fellas, what's happening?
Inspector Clausier. Oh, it's Clouseau, isn't it? Inspector Clouseau here thinks I'm involved in some sort of murder. He's off his fucking head.
Did you hear that? I heard that. He said the words head and off in the same sentence. Keep your distance, PetraChelli. Put your hands out where I can see him. All right, cuff him, Ron.
What? I can't.
Cuff him.
I can't do that.
Cuff him.
I really don't.
Go on, Jesus.
What? I can't.
Cuff the cunt.
I really don't know what to say, dude. Cuff him with what?
No, just ignore him, Kevin.
That's exactly what he wants you to do, Ron. Don't get sucked in.
Oh, just come down off your high horse, Jimmy, for Christ's sakes.
Oi, where'd you get the horse from?
It was over near the emergency flare kit eating a pile of hash cookies. The work crew must have left. What work crew? Fucking work crew.
Oh, fucking high horse. Jesus.
So as the situation worsened with Jimmy's claims of Petra confessing to a murder of some sort, and for furthermore, seeing that he has the confession note in his hot little hand, the quick thinking of Emu Man Kevin Thomas sees the note ripped out of Jimmy's grip and placed into Petra's moisturized, well-moisturized hands, or, well, we all think, what does he get up to? Offset Petra's waiting hand. Petra and Kevin exchange winks, after which it's found that only Petra knowingly winked, whereas Kevin has a nervous twitch in his left eye that causes it to act in an involuntary... It just winks when it wants to. It winks all the time, and it makes it look like it's a wink-like action.
He's got a tick.
Well, you probably shouldn't laugh. You just wink back. Jimmy's on edge and feels that the case that he's built against Petra is strong, but is worried, while Gav wonders why he got wrapped up in all this and all this ludicrous goings-on on the island. And John slaps the horse on the rear to send it on its way, but being smashed on hash cookies, it just falls into a heap and giggles. We haven't had a horse giggle since Mr. Ed. He giggled like Mr. Ed, and Petra reads the confession. He reads it out loud.
Oh, right. This is me confession.
Fucking hell, Ron. After all I've done for you.
You cut my leg off with a chainsaw.
I replaced it!
Right. This is my confession.
You know, my name is not Ron, for God's sakes.
Right, so it goes through. Now I'm just looking for not many W's.
John, there'll be more lines next week. Petra's about to do his confession.
Here we go.
Here he goes. Shh.
Is this the real life? Is this just...
Paragraph 3! You know where it is, Chopper.
Mama just killed a man.
Did you hear that?
Has put gun against his head.
Oh my lord, he's almost bragging.
Pull trigger, knew his deed.
You make me sick.
Mam, life had just begun.
Huh? Practically a newborn.
But now I've gone and thrown it all away.
Disgusting. Disgusting.
Fucking hell, what an idiot.
Fucking tin!
What a dickhead.
You all hear that? You're busted, Chelly.
It's Queen, you fucking tosspot. Fucking Freddie Mercury, you fucking... And all the other dudes, Brian May and fucking the other guy. No one ever remembers his name. It's Queen!
Oh, there'll be plenty of those where he's going.
Be plenty of those when he's gone.
Fuck.
Relax, Jim. Everything's going to be all right.
So as Jimmy's case against Petra gets thrown out of court faster than you can say the limerick, there's a hare in my soup, come and grab it. I would like to think this isn't habit, said the waiter, hold on, sir, you've got it all wrong. There's no hare in your soup, it's a rab... It was a fox or something. I can't quite remember exactly how it went. Oh, who cares? There's a hare in the soup. Take it out or replace the soup. It should be no fast. You shouldn't be writing a limerick over it. So anyway, back to the beach, and the mood is more relaxed. Kev's back doing push-ups in his dingo skin it's an odd singlet. So even on by Kev's standards, it's still an odd singlet. And Petra is enjoying his freedom. Jimmy, for some reason, waves a blue CSI torch over the spot where he found the confession letter, lighting it up like a Christmas tree while a poor sighted octopus 20,000 leagues under the sea holds on tight to a sperm whale he mistook for a submarine. He later let it go and apologized. Which language I must have... I don't know, but John wanders off for a walk while Gav climbs up from the... An athletic Gav climbs up from the rocks below, where he could hear the faint sounds of the missing Pigman's theme music.
I miss the Pigman. Gav, what on earth are you doing down there?
Yeah, Petra, take my hand and help me up. Oh, give me...
I'll do some knowledge as I can, pulling him along.
No, mate. No, no, no. That's a route we don't want to go down. Just help him up from the rocks. That'll do.
Oh, jeez. Lift me up.
Oh, fucking hell, you weigh a fucking ton. Jesus. Oh, fucking hell. Someone ate all the pies.
I found where the music was coming from.
I like that, yeah.
What is it, Gav?
Is it way off the island?
No.
I don't want to go. I built a sandcastle.
He said no, mate.
Is it a shoebox?
It's...
Is it a small sea turtle or puppy?
Why don't you just let him tell you?
I haven't petted a puppy now in... 6 years. Nigel, you bastard.
Oh, dear.
I really don't know what to say, dude.
You know, you still haven't thanked me, Ron. I wasn't going to bring it up, but after this morning's blatant neglect for island public law, section 1, page 1, I've got a good mind to punch you fair in the fucking drumstick.
What for? What the fuck are you even talking about?
Jimmy, have you made up your own island law system that's only got the one law in it so far? Or...
Did you know in some cultures a box with a sea turtle and puppy in it would be seen in the same light as a fruit basket or other offering of food? Like a cake or mashed potatoes or cheese? And that in the Philippines, Polynesia, Mexico, China, Indonesia, Vietnam, Switzerland, the Arctic and Antarctic, you can still buy hot dogs.
Oh, I love the Philippines. I love China. I've no idea where Polynesia is, though. What's that type of television?
No, it's what the bees spread around.
Is it an inst...
Oh, Jimmy, shut up!
Fucker!
Nobody's interested in your nonsense. Everything that comes out your mouth is fucking nonsense. Someone's got something actually interesting to say, and you're fucking waffling on about sea turtles. You don't even know what a sea turtle is. You can barely put your shoes on unassisted. So just shut up.
And how... fucking hell.
Plus, you never answered my questions. I didn't even get this question.
Plus, we haven't even found out what Gav found yet.
Is it an instructional book on how to make a full-sized origami life raft out of the folded pages of the book in question? Oh, please tell me it is. Cross my fingers. Ron, cross your fingers. Hope to die.
It's a Sony cassette player.
Ah, Jesus! Uncross your fingers, Ron.
What is it, Gav? A cassette player?
Yes. With the pig farmer's theme music. Stuck on auto-reverse. This can only mean... one thing.
What?
The crabs down there must be sick of this fucking tune by now.
Oh, I hate it when I've got more than four words. No mention of the batteries being exceptionally well-lasting, or the fact that they're still charged. I mean, it may give us a clue as to some kind of time frame, you know, when the pig farmer went missing.
No. It's just the theme music.
Hey, Petra, look at John. He's talking to a coconut.
I mean, I was good at reading when I was a child. Alphabetic.
He's fucking lost it, mate.
I'll have to put my glasses on. I can't see a fucking thing. Got the dirty, I'll have to clean them. Jimmy knocking my glasses off all the time. I can't fucking see through them. They're filthy.
Jesus wept.
So, as the cassette player is turned off, and John speaks to a coconut, and John was meant to be off walking, it says in the script, in the last script, in the last part where I spoke, I said John went off for a walk, and he's been sticking his nose and he's been saying things, and it's now it's not going to make sense. So as a cassette player is turned off, Brad pockets the batteries for his TV remote back at home on the mainland, while screwing his face up at the thought of licking a 9-volt battery, 12 9-volt batteries, just taped together and give him a good old lick. The young seagull flies in at a great rate of knots, squawking in distress or just showing off. John is still not back. Careful never buy shoes again. Brad watches the seagull fly. Kevin, that's a valid point that Kevin will never buy shoes again. Unless he gets a cobbler. I think it's the cobbler that makes the shoes. And the custom shoes for Kevin. And Brad watches the seagull fly off in the direction he just came from, while Jimmy tells Petra a story about a ruffian named Robert Montague urinating in Bernard Kilkenny's cowboy hat.
I love this bit. Is it in case people don't know I'm Irish already? Jimmy tells Petra a story about a ruffian named Robert Montague urinating in Bernard Kilkenny's cowboy hat. Petra shakes his head. Jimmy does the river dance. What an asshole.
Sorry, Jim, I won't mention it again. Now, where was I? Jimmy does the river dance, hands by side, face forward. Gav moves away. The seagull flies back on purpose. A purpose. fly. It's nowhere near a paw. The seagull flies back.
Oh, g'day, seagull. What's wrong with you today, mate? You're
fucking cunt talking to a seagull.
Look a bit distressed. You sound a bit like a duck. What's that in your beak, little fella? A hair? A curly ginger hair? What are you doing with the hair? Are you building a nest? Is this hair the start of your new ginger hair nest? Is that it?
Geez, that was weird.
Did the seagull just fly off again?
Yeah, and it was behaving very strange. It flew up and gave me this curly ginger hair, and then he just said squawk, 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 squawk. I think that was all. And then he flew off again, and he sounded a bit like a duck, if I'm going to be fair about it. But I don't know what's going on with it. He's just been carrying on a bit lately. So he's acting odd, I tell you that.
You don't think it's trying to tell you something?
Well, I suppose it's possible, but hey, Gav, watch this. You remember them, the batteries out of the remote? I've got some wire and wired them up. Look, hey, Petra, hold on to these wires for me.
It looks like pubic hair. Now, I'm no expert, but this looks like an ungroomed ginger pubic hair.
Ron, look at me.
Come on, man.
Just look at me, Ron! All right, listen. When the seagull comes back, we need you to find out what it's trying to tell us. Okay?
What makes you think I can find out?
Part board.
Oh, I see.
Part board.
I've got it!
You should see a doctor.
What?
Look, here comes the seagull. Is that a pair of...
It's one of John's pubes!
No. No, it's his glasses.
A wazer board like an owl wouldn't fly around holding glasses like that.
Why?
Isn't it obvious? The sun hits the glass, reflects onto the seagull, and burns its own face and board suit off. It's pretty standard safe flight practices.
Oh, is that law too? Judge Judy.
Well, someone's got to be responsible, PetraChelli. Don't forget, I've got my eye on you.
Someone's got to be responsible. You have a cunt that chopped off someone's legs.
Hey, you reckon the seagull could be robbing someone one item at a time?
Oh, why do I have to say it's trying to tell us that John is in trouble? I would never, even if I knew that, I would keep it quiet.
No, you wouldn't.
It's trying to tell us John's in... Oh, I can't do it.
Just do it, mate.
I can't do this.
He's our mate.
Imagine it's someone else. It's trying to tell us John's in trouble.
Johnny Depp.
Is it alopecia?
Have I met her?
Why would you say that?
Ungroomed ginger pubic hair? Jesus Christ, sitting on a swing, you do the math.
Hey, I should follow the seagull and find out...
And find out where he is. I said it first. You should follow the seagull and find out where he is. I'll stay here and build a moat around my little sandcastle.
He's just here.
Who?
The seagull.
Great work, Ron. Is John all right?
What?
Oh, for fuck's sakes.
So as Petra sings for fuck's sakes, and the hoarding seagull risks a mid-flight combustion to help raise the alarm for poor flight captain John Wilson, Jimmy asks Gav if he can use the cassette player he found down amongst the rocks a bit earlier while Brad hands back the batteries and thinks about a time he tried to make a prank phone call to a telemarketer and ended up buying seven soup strainers, a steak knife set, and a whole three seasons, including the Christmas specials of that lovely little series of the 70s. Some mothers do have them. Betty, the cat done a whoopsie on the carpet. The cat done a whoopsie on the carpet. It's one of my favorite Hollywood lines. The seagull flies off. Jimmy, I said the seagull flies off.
What? Oh! Quick! Run, Ron! Chase the seagull! Run like a cunt! You're our only hope!
So as part man, part emu, Kevin Thomas hits top speed, he follows the seagull across the beach, through the jungle, and eventually pulls up a safe distance short to see the man who's been destroying the dreams of sandcastle builders since the 4th of August, 2014, pilot, and former bus driver who also drive double-deckers, John Wilson, stark naked and sitting in, and shit, he's sitting in a huge cooking pot full of warm, lukewarm water, onions chopped up carrot, I can't see what's, I can assume what's, I'd like to know what's in the, what's in there for me, actually, stop the show, stop the music, sorry, chief. Chief. I can't do a proper narration unless I know what's in the pot. Yes, chief. You'll still get paid. Petra, can you quickly run over, race over, and give us a rundown of what's in the pot?
What do you mean, like cooking? What am I clapping my hands for? You're ruining the bloody audio. It's right next to the mic as well.
Dar, you've turned the lights on in my. I've got the lights that you clap, and the lights come on. You've just turned me lights on. Don't clap. Just go over and see what's in the pot. Just tell me what's in the pot, for God's sake.
Well, what do you mean? Like a cooking show type thing?
Well, more just run over and tell me what's in the pot.
Like a Keith Floyd type thing?
Look, just run over and see what's in the pot, for God's sake.
All right, Christ. Hey, Jimmy, pop this cassette in the cassette player and it plays I Get Neighbour Clearing.
Why do you have a cassette tape, Petra?
I always carry it. I have done for years, just on the off chance that I'd get an opportunity like this one. I love Keith Floyd.
What?
I do as well.
Said Captain, I said what? He said Captain, I said what you want? He said Captain, he said what? What do you want me to do?
Just move away from the natives, Ron. Quietly, before they see your legs.
Whoops.
I may have said that too loud. They've all just seen your legs. Sorry, Ron.
Oh, great.
Fucking hell. I don't even know why I've agreed to this shit.
Can't hang in there, mate.
Can I get out of this pot yet or not? It's cold. Can't be. Why is it cold? It should be heating up, surely, Brad.
Well, it's just a prop, mate. We didn't want you burnt.
Is it hot or cold?
It's warm. It's cold.
I can't get out of this pot. It's fucking boiling hot.
It's not. What?
No?
No. No. Oh, fuck it. Whatever.
The water's filthy. I'm going to get shingles. I'm going to get something burnt. I'm going to get rashes and things. I've got shrinkage. I don't get shrinky. Oh, well, I'll do when it's cold, I suppose. Okay. Can I get out of this pot yet or not? It's cold in here. The water's filthy. I'll catch cold. I've got shrinkage. Me Willie, it's disappearing inside myself. These fuckers want to eat me.
To be fair, mate, you don't sound very frightened.
Let that go of that again.
Courageous.
Fucking hell. Fucking hell. Oh, fucking hell. I'm frightened. I don't know why I've agreed to eat. Oh, no, bollocks. I've done it again. Fucking hell.
Ah, quiet, John. So as the tribespeople stare at Kevin's legs, and now shirtless PetraChelli quickly downs a bottle of red wine and makes his way over to the to the cooking pot. Shirtless PetraChelli struts over to the cooking pot.
Well, there's fucking carrots floating around me knob. I've got shrinkage on me knob. It's filth, pure filth. These fuckers want to eat me. I don't know. Pick the bones out of that, as they say.
You're skating on thin ice, John. It's very thin ice over there.
Ah, I wish I could smell this. It's just delicious.
Hey, Jimmy, I think you got to hit play on that tape player, mate.
Whoops! Sorry.
I wish you could smell this. It's unctuous and delicious. The sugar has caramelized around the pieces of meat, or in this case, John Wilson's cock. Not the largest of game birds, but I must add.
Hey, easy, tiger, the old PetraChelli there. Go on, mock me, it's called shrinkage.
No one's looking at your knob,
you
John.
Drunken fucking Cumbrian knobs, fucking beaky.
The coconut milk is reduced and it's ready for the next phase. Have a quick look at that before I get on with it, please, Paul.
The next phase? Just get me out the pot, you knobhead. Untie me and pass me my clothes and we'll get the fuck out of here. I've already started to get annoyed with this, mate. I'm fucking winding me up now. Get me off.
John.
Get me out. In fact, if they light the fire, I'll piss in the soup. That's what I'll do. You know, it's not nice, but I'll piss in your soup, mate. Chef. How'd you like that, eh? Hey? Who the fuck is Paul? Who the fuck's Paul? Hang on. Who the fuck's Paul? Who's Paul?
He's me cameraman.
Do it like Keith.
He's my cameraman. This is a television show, you know. This is a TV production.
You've lost me, man. There is no cameraman. There's no fucking camera. not on camera. We're no camera. There's no camera. Is there a camera? Hello?
Don't spoil it for me, John.
Hey, I'm John Wilson. Welcome.
Don't
Hello, everybody.
John.
It'd be all over it like a rash. There's no camera here. Just me and this fucking pot.
You know, it's like Jekyll and Hyde, miss.
For God's sake, stop complaining, John. You always have to be a killjoy. I'm enjoying this. Brad's enjoying it.
I'm loving it.
Jimmy.
Yeah?
Are you enjoying this?
Yeah. I wish I had a pen or even a pencil.
To write down the recipe? Good idea.
No. To use as a tent peg.
Are you missing a tent peg?
No, I'm missing a tent. But at least I'd have a tent peg. It's a start.
Hey, Gav, would you be interested in a box set of Some Mothers Do Have 'Em at all?
No.
No? It's coming on the Christmas, just a Christmas present idea.
No. Thank you.
Oh, no worries. Petra, you've got a copy of the... Have you got a copy of... Where did you get it from?
It's from you, you dickhead.
What about when Frank Spencer wrecks the hen house?
What an idiot.
I don't know what that was. I don't know what that was.
Can you bloke shut up? I'm trying to do a show over here.
Ooh, Kate's back.
This is a production, you know.
Sorry, mate.
Arr, turn the music off. Jimmy, turn the music off. Ah, Petra, all you have to do is tell me what's in the pot. It's a simple job. You don't need to set up a cooking show, bring in your own cameraman and knock back two bottles of red wine to explain what's in a fucking cooking pot. Just tell me what's in the cooking pot.
Look, pal, you do it your way. I'll do it Keith's. I mean, I'll do it my way. Jimmy, start cassette tape again.
Bit of help over here, guys. In a concerned bit panic type voice.
Oh, look, the natives have picked up Ron. And rolling in 3, 2, 1.
Yo, dudes, bit of help over here.
Now then, the prawn garnish, or in this case, looks like they've just brought in a prawn replacement. Kevin Thomas.
Little help over here, brothers.
Pop him in with the coconut milk, please, lads. Smashing. Let's soak for a bit. Add a bit of garlic and some shallots that we cooked earlier. Ouch. That's fine, that's only a ball hitting me. The tribe's getting a bit restless. They've started a game of volleyball in the background. You didn't even see that, did you? I was injured by an enemy, but by a ball. Depending on which side you were on. B team got me there, you see. I'm hoping the Reds will win, sorry. Anyway.
Oh, fuck, he's pissed, the wine's taking effects. Narrator!
What?
You'll have to put him out, you'll have to get him out of there. He's getting messy, he's saying stuff.
Well, all he had to do was go and check what was in the pot. It's a sim. He made a whole song and dance. You make your bed, you sleep in it with the fleas and all the things. Turn the fucking music off, Jim. Can't hear myself think.
Oh, God. Do you think they might eat John Wilson and Ron, Mr. Wonker? Do you think they'll be eaten alive?
Calm down, Jim. They won't be eaten alive.
But how can you be so sure? You don't know what these people are capable of. How can you be so confident?
Because they've just lit the fire.
Hey,
oh,
hey,
fair point.
They've lit the fire. How did they light the fire? They got Brad's lighter or something. They've lit the fire. Come on.
So as Petra staggers off set, and the island goes back to the script, the men act fast to rescue Kevin and John before the natives realize they're there. They are there. They're there. Meanwhile, in northern Alaska, a young Inuit lights a fire inside the family igloo while his parents are out, causing the roof to melt and the carpet to get all wet and eventually smelly. Smelt like fish and whatever comes in on their boots. Petra is now standing still and talking to Paul, his imaginary cameraman, about how he thought the show went. Things for Kevin and John are heating up. Properly heating up. Arr, sounds a bit gay.
Music, Jim.
Oh.
The lunch will be a palpable hit. They'll love it and insist I immediately join as a warrant officer, second class jungle division. Sadly, I'd have to decline. But there was something lurking that I knew just had to be faced. Yes, they were about to cook John and Kevin. Oh, fuck me, they're about to cook John and Kevin. Get up my way, Paul. Do something, Jim. Distract them somehow.
So as reality hits Petra right between the eyes, Jimmy throws Petra's cassette tape containing the Keith Floyd theme music away, whilst inserting one of his own, a recording of some traditional Irish music he can river dance to.
Right, well, you better pick up my Keith Floyd bloody cassette tape, Nobby.
The natives hear the music and turn to see Jimmy jigging up and down like Michael Flatley, with his arms by his side and his eyes on the prize. He takes their attention away for long enough for Gav, Brad, and celebrity crook PetraChelli to sweep in from the side and untie the two marinated men of the pot and make their getaway, while the dancing man of Dublin slams his foot down hard to end the dance. The natives don't give chase. To be honest, they were just paid actors. But don't tell the boys that. Be our little secret. The men walk down towards the beach, happy to be safe once again. Well, almost safe. John, put some pants on. It's meant to be a family show. John's shrinkage.
Put some pants on. I haven't got my pants on now. I always sit and do the old show with no pants on.
John, that's not the kind of image we're trying to project, mate.
Just likes to let things run free around the old nads.
I don't care.
Put some fucking pants on. Christ, why did I need to be the one running around stark fucking balls dangly naked in a show where the audience can't see if I've got pants on or not? Eh?
That was a joke, John. Besides, I could see a few of the tribe's women enjoyed it. They were giggling and pointing with their spears. We had to get you to cover up because the seagull thought it was a chip.
Well, I'm not happy, and fuck all the lines. I'm naked. I've got a reputation to try and keep, for fuck's sake. I'm keeping track. Keeping tack. Fuck it. And keeping tack. No, katacked. Tacked. You missed the T off. I just read what you write. Well, I'm not happy. I've got fuck all lines. I'm naked. I've got a reputation to keep intact. And I'm running around fucking Fantasy Island with fucking tattoo there with a fucking beaky nose. You know who you are. Some burnt knob. Only all you blokes can do is laugh. Knob rots.
Fucking hell, this is hard work. This was a lot easier when I was drunk.
I never had to put up with this kind of shit when I was flying planes and driving buses. Oh, they were good days, the old bus days, you
Fuck
know.
You,
planes.
Get on with it.
Nice. I was dapper. I looked dapper. Nice trousers, white shirt. That was the fucking dog's bollocks.
Well, you shouldn't have crashed the fucking plane then, John.
You shot me out the fucking...
Oh, here we go. You're like a broken record.
Broken record? You keep going on about the fucking stupid fucking sandcastle. Fucking sick to death, a bit tosser.
Nudist.
Child.
Am not.
Also.
I am not.
Also.
I fucking am not, John.
You are. You bloody are the child.
Am not.
Grow up, man.
Stop the music.
For fuck's sake.
One more time, John. One more time and I'll be telling my mother. Okay, now start the music back up so we can finish this thing. Okay, right. Christ, tensions are high. Where were we? As a young seagull thinks a thought much similar to John's, but in this case, involving exploitation and not nudity, John makes his way to the water's edge. Jimmy makes his way to the water's edge, not John. He's got me so confused. He looks down to see a hermit crab wearing his beloved...
Wilson's sister?
Oh, here we go.
It can't be. It is! It's Wilson's sister!
Ah, there you go, Jim. So as Jimmy's long-lost love of the island is found, working as a house of crab, the island is quickly filled with music while Jimmy spins his way down the beach singing a Beach Boys classic to his returned sports ball mistress. Everyone joins in. The sun moves into a conveniently romantic position. The seagull sways.
You never need to doubt it. I'll make you so sure about it. God only knows what I'd be without you. If you should ever leave me, though life would still go on, believe me,
the world could show nothing to me.
So what good would living do me?
God only knows what I'd be without you.
Sorry. sorry, Wilson's sister. Got a cough.
God only knows. What a bloody good title that is. God only knows. Rock and roll. This rock and roll. This is the highlight.
God only knows what I'd be without you.
If you should ever leave me,
well, life would still go on, believe me.
The world could show nothing to me,
so what good would living do me? God only knows what I'd be without.
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 God only knows what I'd be.
God only knows.
God only knows what I'd be without.
God only knows what I'd be.
God only knows.
God only knows what I'd be without.
God only knows.
Creature of story. Is this the God of the Old Testament? An angry God, a wrathful God, a human God even, brutal? Or is this God of the New Testament? Distant, like a distant father.
God only knows what I'd be without you.
God only knows.
God doesn't know. God knows nothing of you. God doesn't know you.
Oh, holy fuck.
Next week on Shipwrecked, Shipwrecked, Shipwrecked. Something he said about someone that no one's ever met. A suggestion to compete in a complete the raft. Yeah, the boys thought about building a few episodes ago, gets laughed at. And they find three blind mice and see how they run. All that and one fine seagull next week in another exciting episode of Some Mothers Do... in another episode of Shipwrecked. Shipwrecked. Ah, Shipwrecked.
I would love to have a cooking show. I think I'd be great at it, honestly. There's a lot of crap on... There's a fella over here, Brad, called Eston Summit. He's this bald fella with weird glasses, and he just cooks anything and gets paid millions. Like, he'll go out and find a sparrow and cover it in chocolate and serve it to you with a bloody toothpick, and it's a taste sensation. He's a little knobhead. Can we not just leave fucking Johnny in the pot?